Good morning, friend. Today is a special day. As an author, today is the day when my next book is birthed. It's called The Hem of His Garment, Reaching Out to God When Pain Overwhelms. I can't really describe it, but there's something special about this book that holds a special place in my heart, more than any of the other books I've ever written. And I put my heart and soul in all of my books, but there's something about this book. Perhaps it's because it was written in the crucible of pain. Perhaps it was because it was written with you in mind. As I wrote, I continually thought about several individuals specifically who were going through either physical or emotional or relational or financial or spiritual pain, grief or loss. And I thought, what does my reader need who's struggling in the midst of pain, who wonders, will it ever end? And can I live this way in pain? If you'll indulge me for just a moment, I want you to hear my heart for you as the reader. So it comes from the introduction. It says, "Let me link arms with you. Dear fellow pain sojourner, I wept in pain through the night and early this morning, praying not only for my own healing from pain, but also for the physical, emotional, spiritual, relational, and financial healing of so many I know and love, as well as for you, dear reader. Years of enduring different types of pain have humbled me and made me grateful for the pain that Christ experienced on our behalf. He paid for our sickness, our sin, our brokenness, our imperfection, and our pain, knowing we could never truly appreciate it this side of heaven. I want you to know that you will experience victory on the other side of your pain journey, and that your victories are worth fighting for, but you don't fight alone. I've experienced each type of pain I've written about in this book. I come to you not as one who no longer suffers, but rather as someone who knows the loneliness that accompanies the journey through pain, and offers to link arms with you so you will feel less alone. In our own strength, we may feel weak, but our faith is in a very strong God. It is my prayer that as you read through these pages, you will grow through the pain that you go through. Hope lets us get up and face each day, pain-ridden as it may be, unsure of what it holds, but confident in the one who holds it. Will you hold on to hope with me as we take this journey together? God isn't just the God of heavenly thrones, churches, Bible studies, and revivals. He's also the God of chemotherapy chairs, overdrawn bank accounts, prodigal children, empty chairs at holiday dinners, bathroom floors, broken hearts, and tear-stained pillows. He's a God who stoops and bends his ear to listen to our heartfelt cries. He's the God who promises to go before, walk alongside, and come behind us when no one else will. I pray that as you read this book, you'll encounter him in a fresh new way through your pain and reach out to touch the hem of his garment. Linking arms with you, Dr. Michelle. Friend, this book was written in the crucible of pain. I was going through some pretty horrific chronic pain, and I still am. I remember when the publisher asked me to write this book, I thought, I don't know what to tell them. What hope can I give them? I'm still in the midst of it myself. And you know what I found is that in our most horrendous pain, that's sometimes when we realize that we're most dependent on God. And very dependent on God as I wrote this book. I've asked God a lot of the hard questions that most of us don't want to admit. God, do you care about me? God, do you see me? God, I know you can heal. Why aren't you healing me? And you know what? I found it's okay to ask those hard questions. God's big enough to handle our questions, our doubts, our fears, and even our pain. And this book is out now. It was written for you, or maybe someone you know and love. And if you're fortunate to not be one experiencing one of those kinds of pain right now, perhaps you could consider gifting it to your pastor or counselor or life coach or mentor or teacher or women's ministry leader. All of those who are in a position where they're ministering to the hurting and they need biblically based, hope-filled perspective resources. That's what I hope this book is for you and all who read it. And by the way, I'm not done praying for you. When I pray for my own healing, I'm praying for yours as well. And if you have already gotten a copy of The Hem of His Garment, I'd love to hear what you think of it. What resonated with you? What hit the mark? I'd love to know. It's my honor and joy to share this labor of love with you. And it's my heartfelt prayer that it's a blessing to you.